I'm your host, Patrick, along with
Nick.
Today is May 1st.
It's a day A.
Today in history, on May 1st, 1931, the Empire State Building is dedicated in New York City.
Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. Because of testing, the ETV quiz will be moved to Friday, both on this week and next week. And now for today's announcements with Michael and Evan.
What does today's weather look like? Today's sunny with temperatures rising towards the mid-60s. Tonight, generally clear, low near 45 degrees. Now here's Michael with today's announcements.
Thank you, Evan. Permission slip and deposit for the 8th grade chorale and band trip to Dorney Park are due today to Mr. Dunno. This is a reminder to all track and field athletes. Practice today is canceled. We will be practicing Thursday and Friday. Again, there is no track practice today. See Mr. Ski or Mrs. Keller for any questions. There will be a Battle of the Books meeting Thursday, tomorrow, in room 508. There will be a Brain Busters meeting today after school in room 517. Here's Evan with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Michael. There's a 90-minute baseball practice today after school. Players should bring any baseball forms. Today is Wednesday, and only core tie classes are available for students. Open labs, phys ed, world language, art, and home ec are not available to students on Wednesdays. Attention, all intramural volleyball players, we will have games after school tomorrow, Thursday in the gym. See you there. Are we celebrating any birthdays?
There are no birthdays today. What's for lunch today?
Lemon chicken over rice with green beans. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Lasagna roll up with salad. What's in the headlines?
Wall Street bankers and some of the world's top finance ministers are waging a bitter campaign to block Washington financial regulators from extending their political powers far beyond the nation's shores. Today is our last show. And now for today's feature with
Jamie
and Lexi.
So, Jamie, did you have fun making your dead Fred?
Yeah, it was cool drawing different organs.
Now let's watch this feature on dead Fred.
In 8th grade science this year, we're learning about the human body.
As an experiment to find out what's inside the human body, we built a life-size model called dead Fred.
But don't be scared. The worst it could do to you is give you a paper cut or a bad grade.
Let's see what Eisenhower's 8th grade students thought of dead Fred.
So, Miss Wernsey, what is dead Fred?
Well, this is dead Fred, and it is a model of the human body, and students have to create each body part for the major systems. So, this is what it looks like when it's all completed.
How long did dead Fred take?
It took about 2 weeks with a couple days of research and creating our QR codes.
How did your students do with this?
I would say, for the most part, they did an extraordinary job. Some of the body parts are a little misshapen, but for the most part, they look exactly like the human body.
Thank you.
So what parts of the body did you have to build?
I had to build the digestive system.
Should the teachers do this again next year?
Yeah, definitely. I had a lot of fun with my group.
So what parts of dead Fred did you construct?
I constructed the jelly-like substance called the brain.
What did you think of dead Fred?
Just thinking about it kind of makes me emotional because the whole project pretty much gave me anxiety and it didn't go well for my group.
Should the teachers do this again next year?
No, they should not.
Why?
I feel like it will not only kill many trees by a waste of construction, but also give students severe problems.
What parts of dead Fred did you construct?
I constructed the respiratory system.
Do you think the teachers should do this next year for the incoming 8th graders?
I think they should because it was really educational and taught us about the parts of the body.
As you can see, most students and teachers love Dead Fred, and we hope to carry it on in the upcoming years.
Get ready, 7th graders, because Dead Fred's coming for you next.
Looks like everyone had a lot of fun with this project.
Today's our last show. And now, back to us,
Patrick
and Nick.
Thanks, Lexi
and Jamie.
And now for the joke of the day.
Hey, Patrick, did you hear what happened to that dog that swallowed the watch?
No, what happened to it?
He got a lot of ticks.
Oh. Thanks for watching.
Have a We're Still Testing Wednesday.